Estimate the cell potential of Daniel cell, which had originally 1 molar zinc ions, 1 molar copper ions. After adding sufficient ammonia to RHS of the cell to make the concentration of ammonia as 2 molar. Given SRP of zinc minus 0.76, SRP of copper plus 0.34 volts. And equilibrium constant for the formation of ammonia is also given to us. Now here, they are adding ammonia to RHS side. That means they are adding ammonia to copper ions containing electrode. So because of this, what happens is copper ion is forming a complex with ammonia. Due to this, concentration of copper ions get reduced. So that new concentration of copper ions we have to calculate using equilibrium constant, which is given to us. So we can say there are three steps altogether in the problem. See, step one will be like this. Step one will be calculation of E naught of cell. Step two will be calculation of concentration of copper ions now. Using equilibrium constant given to us. Then third one, calculation of EMF of cell using new concentration of copper ions. There are three steps we have. Let us start step one first. That is what? Calculation of E naught of cell. So, we know that E naught of cell is equal to E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode, which is equal to cathode is copper here. So, plus 0.34 minus of minus anode is zinc here now. The value comes to 1.1 volt we have. That is E naught value we found out. Second thing is calculation of concentration of copper ion. This is the most important step in the reaction. This is a process. So for this, we are writing first of all the equation now. That is Cu plus 2 forms complex with ammonia. So 4 ammonia here, giving rise to. The complex formula is already given in the question only. The complex here now. So we require initially what is the concentration of copper ions now. Initial concentration of copper ions is 1 molar you have now. Then final concentrations. Means after reaching equilibrium, concentrations or final concentrations. Final concentration, assume that we have x molar of copper ions left off. Final concentration. What about ammonia? They're adding sufficient amount of ammonia such a way that final concentration is 2 molar now. Final concentration is 2 molar. Then comes how much amount of copper complex forms. For this, what we have to do is, we have to observe the equilibrium constant given to us. See, the value given to us is equilibrium constant value is 10 to the power of 12. This point is most important for us. 10 power 12 is given means very, very large value. That implies reaction almost all goes to completion. Means whatever copper ion you are taking the concentration, everything will be coming out as complex only. So we can take now the concentration of copper ions, copper ion complex is 1 molar now. Then how about final concentration of copper ions here now? We cannot take copper concentration left as 0 because equilibrium cannot exist. Means negligibly small amount of copper ion remains. That small amount we have taken it as x molar now. So these are the three equilibrium moles. Now using equilibrium constant, we have to find out what is the concentration of here copper ions now. So they are given as equilibrium constant there. that is Kf is given to us, formation constant. So Kf is equal to concentration of complex here, that is Cu complex concentration, okay, by concentration of Cu plus 2, that is leftover into concentration of ammonia we have now. But to the power of 4 comes now. Now we need to substitute these values there now. So Kf is given as 10 to the power of 12, which is equal to concentration of copper complex is 1 ferrous divided by X is a copper ferrous into you have ammonia is 2 molar, 2 to the power of 4 you are going to get now. So 2 power 4, we need to solve the complete question there. Therefore, finally, the value of X, it comes to 0.0625 into 10 to the power of minus 12. This is a concentration of copper ions left. Means new concentration of copper ions we can say now. Now we need to apply the Nernst equation and then find out the new potential of the cell. So now here, Nernst equation now is a Daniell cell given to us, no? So therefore we can take directly E is equal to E naught of cell minus 0.0591 by 2 into log of concentration of zinc ions by concentration of we have copper ions now. Already we found out E naught of cell, which is 1.1 there, minus 0.0591 by 2 into log of. So zinc ion is 1 molar only by copper ion concentration. Just now we found out there 0.0625 into 10 to the power of minus 12 we have now. Is also equal to 1.1 minus 0.0591 by 2. You can take inverse of this. It comes to like this now. Log of 16 into 10 to the power of 12 will come, which is equal to 1.1 minus 0.0591 by 2 into, it can be taken as log of 16 plus log of 10 to the power of 12 we can write. This must be simplified further, okay? And the answer comes to 0.7098. This is the final answer we have.